How can we compute complex numbers like I to the power I? So say numbers of the form z to the power c, where both z and c are complex numbers. Well, that looks hard. However, if you know the complex logarithm, this is not difficult at all, as you will learn in this video. So, what do we know about real functions? In the real case, x to the power a equals e to the power ln x to the power a, and you can take the a in front, so you get e to the power a times the ln of x. So in the real case, you can define all those powers in terms of the logarithm, as soon as you know the exponential function. Well, we know exponential function and logarithm, so we can do the same for the complex functions, and that's how we will define the complex power functions. Z to the power c is just e to the power c times log of z, complete analogon of its real counterpart. Of course, you can only do that if z is not equal to zero. Well, you immediately see that we have a small log over here, so your complex function becomes multivalued. Now you can make this function again single valued, familiar way. That's called the principal value of your power power function z to the power c, and it equals e to the power c log of z, but now with the capital L, so where we take the principal value of the log. So let us do some computations with that. Well, we can start with computing, for example, I to the power I. Well, that's by definition e to the power I log I, it's a small log, and we know how to compute the log of I, that equals the ln of the modulus plus I times the argument, k times 2 pi I. So if we simplify a bit, we get e to the power minus pi over 2 minus k times 2 pi. So we see that I to the power I becomes a real number. Not the value, of course, but if we take the principal value of I to the power I, which boils down to taking k equals 0, we get e to the power minus pi over 2. Now, we can also compute a number like minus 1 to the power 1 over pi. In order to do so, we need the log of minus 1 first. So the log of minus 1 equals the ln of the modulus of minus 1, so the ln of 1 equals 0, plus I times the argument equals pi, plus k times 2 pi I, again. And that allows us to compute minus 1 to the power 1 over pi equals e to the power 1 over pi times this log over here, which simplifies to e to the power I times 1 plus 2 times k. So minus 1 to the power 1 over pi looks quite odd, some complex number now. Now, in our third example, we will take principal values only. So we will take all the time only principal values. Now we are going to check whether some familiar rules still hold. Like what happens if you take z1 times z2 to the power I, z equal to z1 to the power I times z2 to the power I. We take a few examples. We take z1 equals 1 plus I, z2 1 minus I, z3 minus 1 minus I, z3 equals minus z1. So z1 times z2 equals 2, and z2 times z3 equals minus 2. And then we are going to take all the from all of them the i's power. So z1 to the power I equals e to the power I log of 1 plus I. What's the log of 1 plus I? And the modulus of 1 plus I equals the square root of 2, and its argument equals pi over 4. So we get e to the power I ln times square root of 2 plus I times pi over 4. And we can rewrite it as e to the power minus pi over 4 plus I of 2 times ln of 2, because the ln of the square root of 2 equals the ln of 2 to the power 1 half equals 1 half times the ln of 2. So we have z1 to the power I. Z2 to the power I is very similar. Then we get log of 1 minus I instead. So instead of argument plus pi over 4, we get argument minus pi over 4 over here. But the only thing which happens is that we get e to the power pi over 4. Then what about z3? We get a minus 1 minus I. So the only thing which changes with respect to the first one is that now our argument will be minus 3 pi over 4. So we get the minus I times 3 pi over 4 over here, and the e to the power 3 pi over 4 over there. Okay, those were z1, z2, and z3. Now the products, well, those are a bit easier. Z1 times z2 to the power I equals e to the power log 2, which is just e to the power ln of 2. And z2 times z3 to the power I equals e to the power I log of minus 2. So the only thing which happens is that we get an argument of plus pi over here, it yields e to the power minus pi. So, what do we see now? If we take z1 to the power I times z2 to the power I, so this one times that one, the factors e to the power pi over 4 cancel out, and we get e to the power I over 2 times ln 2, 2 times. So we get e to the power I times the ln of 2. And it happens to be the same as z1 times z2 to the power I. Isn't that nice? Well, it's only sort of a coincidence that it happens, because if you take z2 to the power I times z3 to the power I, you get an e to the power I, plus again I times ln of 2, and that is not equal to z2 times z3 to the power I, because that is e to the power minus pi plus I times ln of 2. So you see, in general, this familiar rule, z1 times z2 to the power c equals z1 to the power c times z2 to the power c, does not hold anymore. So be careful with power series, because your familiar rules may not hold anymore.